हेलो नमस्ते, माई सेल्फ एम एस भास्करगांव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड साइंसेस, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सक्सेसिव डिफरेंशिएशन पार्ट टू, लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू फाइंड एंड द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ अलजेब्रिक फंक्शन। See, in the first video already we have seen how to find the end derivative of a given function, that is algebraic function, and we have developed the formula and we have seen the examples. We will see few more examples on finding the end derivative of algebraic function. Now first example is find the end derivative of 1 upon 6x square minus 5x plus 1. Let y equal to 1 upon 6x square minus 5x plus 1. To apply the general formula of nth derivative, here we, first of all we have to factor, because this is a in the denominator you have quadratic equation is there. First of all you have to factorize this as a product of two linear factors. See here we have 6x square minus 5x plus 1. We can write 6x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 1. Here we have adjust the middle term such that here we are adjusting the middle term such that their product is plus 6 and sum is minus 5. That is product of minus 2 and minus 3 is plus 6, that is satisfying, and sum of minus 2 and minus 3, that is minus 5. And now in the first two term we are taking here 2x is common, and here 2x into bracket 3x will remain minus 1, and here we are taking the minus sign common, 3x minus 1. Therefore, taking 3x minus 1 common, you get factors are 2x minus 1 into 3x minus 1. Therefore, we can write the given function y equal to 1 upon 6x square minus 5x plus 1 as 1 upon 2x minus 1 into 3x minus 1. Now, again, here we'll go for partial fraction because we have to apply the formula of 1 upon ax plus b. Let 1 upon 2x minus 1 into bracket 3x minus 1 equal to a upon 2x minus 1 plus b upon 3x minus 1, because both the factors are linear and distinct. By using the property of partial fraction, we have written this expression. Now multiplying both sides by 2x minus 1 into 3x minus 1, we get left hand side will remain 1 is equal to a into 3x minus 1 plus b into 2x minus 1. Now we have to find the values of a and b. For that we have to choose the suitable values of x. Now to find a, putting x equal to 1 by 2, now we have to put x equal to 1 by 2 here both side, putting we have to put x equal to 1 by 2, left hand side will be 1 only. Then what to get? 1 is equal to a into bracket 3 by 2 minus 1, that is 1 is equal to 3 by 2 minus 1, that is 1 by 2 a. Therefore, a equal to what you get? 2. And to find b, putting x equal to 1 by 3, you get 1 left hand side is 1 is equal to b into bracket 2 by 3 minus 1, that is 1 equal to minus 1 by 3 b. Therefore, the value of b is minus 3. Now, substituting the values of a and b, substituting the values of a and b here, therefore we can write the given expression as y equal to 2 upon 2x minus 1 minus 3 upon 3x minus 1. Now we already seen the end derivative formula. If y equal to 1 upon ax plus b, then yn equal to end derivative is minus 1 raised to n into n factorial into a raised to n divided by ax plus b raised to n plus 1. And now we'll compare these two terms with 1 upon ax plus b. In this case, a is 2, b is minus 1. And in second case, a is 3 and b is minus 1. Therefore, comparing with this formula, we'll write the end derivative of this first term as yn equal to, keeping this constant 2 as it is, minus 1 raised to n into n factorial into a raised to n. Means here a is 2, therefore 2 raised to n divided by 2x minus 1 raised to n plus 1, that is ax plus b raised to n plus 1. This first term is about the end derivative of 2 upon 2x minus 1. Now here keeping this minus sign as it is and 3 as it is, and the nth derivative of 1 upon 3x minus 1 is minus 1 raised to n into n factorial into a raised to n means 3 raised to n divided by 3x minus 1 raised to n plus 1. This is what the n derivative of the given function. Now pause the video for a while and find the n derivative of x upon x square minus 4. Pause the video and find the n derivative of this function. I hope you have completed. Now let y equal to x upon x square minus 4, that is a given function, and here we have to factorize this. Factorization is very simple. Here we can make use of a square minus b square. We can write x square minus 4 as x square minus 2 square, and factors are x minus 2 into x plus 2 using a square minus b square equal to a minus b into a plus b. Therefore, we can write x upon x square minus 4 equal to x upon x minus 2 into x plus 2, and we have to make use of partial fraction. Let x upon x minus 2 into x plus 2 is equal to a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x plus 2. Therefore, multiplying both sides by x minus 2 into x plus 2, you get x is equal to a into bracket x plus 2 plus b into x minus 2. Now to find a and b, you can put x equal to 2 and x equal to minus 2. Putting x equal to 2 both sides, we get left hand side is 2, 2 plus 2, that is 4, 4a, and second term will become 0. 2 equal to 4a, therefore a equal to 1 by 2. Now putting x equal to minus 2 both sides, left hand side is minus 2, which is equal to here b into minus 2, minus 2, that is minus 4b, therefore b equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, given function we can write as y equal to 1 by 2 into 1 upon x minus 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1 upon x plus 2. And therefore, yn is equal to 1 by 2 into bracket using the formula of 1 upon ax plus b minus 1 raised to n into n factorial divided by x minus 2 raised to n plus 1 plus minus 1 raised to n into n factorial divided by x plus 2 raised to n plus 1. And by simplifying, we get, we can take common minus 1 raised to n and n factorial, that is minus 1 raised to n into n factorial divided by 2 into bracket 1 upon x minus 2 raised to n plus 1 plus 1 upon x plus 2 raised to n plus 1. Now we'll see the next example. Find the n derivative of x upon x plus 2 raised to 4. Find the n derivative of x upon x plus 2 raised to 4. Let y equal to x upon x plus 2 raised to 4. Now see here, x plus 2 is repeated 4 times, and here we have to adjust the term and we have to express this in the form of 1 upon ax plus b. See, we can write here x upon x plus 2 raised to 4 can be written as x plus 2 minus 2, that is here we have added 2 and we have subtracted 2 without changing, that is x will remain, same expression will remain. Just in place of x, we are written x plus 2 minus 2 divided by x plus 2 raised to 4. Next, which is equal to x plus 2 divided by x plus 2 raised to 4 means 1 upon x plus 2 raised to 3 minus 2 upon x plus 2 raised to 4. Now see, in the first video, we have seen if y equal to 1 upon ax plus b raised to m, then yn is equal to m plus n minus 1 factorial into minus 1 raised to n divided by m minus 1 factorial into a raised to n divided by ax plus b raised to m plus n. Now here we have to compare with the given expression with 1 upon ax plus b raised to m. See here, a is 1 and b is 2, and here in this first case m is 3. Therefore, yn is equal to, we can write m plus n minus 1 factorial. Here m is 3, that is 3 plus n minus 1 factorial into minus 1 raised to n divided by m minus 1 factorial, means 3 minus 1 factorial, into 1 upon x plus 2 raised to 3 plus n. This was the n derivative of the first term, minus keeping 2 as it is, and n derivative of 1 upon x plus 2 raised to 4 is 4 plus n minus 1 factorial into minus 1 raised to n divided by 4 minus 1 factorial. In this above formula, putting m equal to 4 into 1 upon x plus 2 raised to 4 plus n. I hope you understood. Just we are comparing this above formula. We get this one. Now further we will simplify, which is equal to, therefore y n equal to what to get? Minus 1 raised to n, n plus 2 factorial. Just here we are simplifying this one. 3 plus n minus 1 factorial. We can write n plus 2 factorial, that is minus 1 raised to n into n plus 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial into x plus 2 raised to n plus 3 minus 2 into minus 1 raised to n into n plus 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial into x plus 2 raised to n plus 4. And here in both term taking minus 1 raised to common, which is equal to minus 1 raised to n into bracket n plus 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial is 2 into x plus 2 raised to n plus 3 minus n plus 3 factorial as it is, and here 2 by 3 factorial means 1 by 3 are kept as it is, that is n plus 3 factorial divided by 3 into x plus 2 raised to n plus 4. This is what the n derivative of the given function. References: Higher Engineering Mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal. Thank you.